So this last presentation is about computational coupling cost evaluation for this new generation of Earth system model in which we are working, no? Increasing the complexity. So well, this is trivia information for you, no? About coupled model application. We are going to only take into account these three particular points and from the computational point of view. So this coupling data, the most important here for this typical computational evaluation is that we require extra computation for all this interpolation, and some of them could increase, could add some constraints, for example, the conservation for the interpolation that we are doing. Also, we have to do this transfer, the data transfer, so we are including more communication using FDI communication, for example. And also the coordination among the different components is going to be important for the final computational efficiency, as we are going to show for some different examples. So it's true that sometimes this coordination is going to be trivial and there is no problem, but others, this waiting time among components could be a problem. So this is the question, no? Are we sure that our models and the workflow that we are using is ready to evaluate the computational efficiency of the coupled implementation? Probably yes, probably for most of your execution just right now. But the question that we are going to try to show you to prove with example is, are we 100% that the setup that you are choosing is the best one in terms of computational efficiency? Finally, with the next one, and actually, we are moving to more complex Earth system model, no? So maybe you are now with three components, and we are moving for the next iteration with the next iteration of component models, six, seven, whatever. So the question here is, for this new situation, have we a methodology to try to do this computational analysis? And finally, are we sure actually that we have to do this manually, or there is some way to take these metrics and try to do the evaluation in some automatic way? So these are our main goals and probably also the conclusion about this particular work. We are working to define a new common set of performance metrics to evaluate these coupled models through Lucia tool inside the. So we are using a standard coupler as is OASIS in collaboration with Fairfax. So the main goal is this computational evaluation, but actually is reduce the execution cost of each component and also the system model as a whole. And finally, try to say some way to establish a method to try to balance all these different components, all the different setups that we are using for the Earth system models. So to try to provide you some context, we are going to give you some example about the new metric that we are proposing. And for this, this is the particular model, ECR. Actually, Uwe provide more information in a previous talk. So we are coming for this NEMO IFS, which actually is also including XIOS for the output of NEMO and RoundMapper. But we are moving to this new Earth system model configuration with six components. So now about these three particular point, communication, computation, coordination, we are talking about six component for the coordination to exchange over 200 fields every 6 hours and with some interpolation will require, for example, conservative operation. So also you can see that we have different scalability curve, different resolution of output configuration, irregular time steps. We are going to see later why this is a problem for the performance evaluation and these kind of things for something that is more complex than in the past. So we are coming from here. No, this is a starting point. Lucia is a tool which was developed some years ago by Fairfax and is inside OASIS. So Lucia is providing three metrics. Is in summary is the waiting time, the model computation plus interpolation time, and jitter to try to provide more information between some, for example, the first and the last process. So this is the typical output in which we can see how the component interact, and also take into account, please, that we are talking here about the final execution time per component after the simulation that we have done. Okay. So something that we require for the new metrics. So we are coming from here and this currently with this particular metrics and the method that typically the state of the art recommend is minimize this waiting time. Normally try to make all components to run at the same simulation yesterday. And this objectives is the new metric that also we propose to include with the in the coupling cost evaluation that we are going to explain later and also with some examples. So a method that we recommend now is minimize the waiting time while having the best number of processes, but in this case, is taking into account the efficiency, the number of resources that we are using, and time to solution. Try to also highlight that currently is not bad and the new one is not good. Actually, we are collaborating with Fairfax. They are doing a new approach for to collect the data. And well, the only idea here is that we have to improve the metric that we are using and we have to provide more information and we are collaborating to do this. So this is the typical, no? Simulation just per day and core hour per year simulator. The only important point to highlight here is that we are going to introduce this particular metrics not only for the couple execution, but only per component. And we will say later that this could be useful. And now also we introduce in the same one, the component waiting component is the execution time of the component itself. Waiting time, the interpolation that you can see in this case as is not too much, and sending that actually with asynchronous communication is negligible. And we are introducing also now the dependencies graph. So this is going to be very useful because usually when you know the waiting time that you are producing for the couple execution, with this particular metrics or graph, you can now see if this waiting time is coming from one particular component or another. And we will see this in the example. And also we are presenting the decoupling interval. So the idea is that we were working with accumulative or average metrics with the total execution time per component and for the couple execution. But now we can also see this coupling interval, which is the interval between consecutive coupling regions. So these are regular time steps. So this is per time step of, for example, here IFS and NIMO. And in this case, we can see the particular pattern and with irregular time step, we can see in which particular time steps one component or another are waiting. Also, we are introducing the new metrics, this coupling cost, which is a standard metric, which is coming from the performance metrics defined by Balaji et al. Some years ago. And actually, we are using this particular performance metrics to collect a lot of information, for example, for CIMIC-6 in ESNS3. So we are introducing this coupling cost, which is going to evaluate the total processes, the number of processes that you are using for the model and the component, and the time for the couple execution and per component. But also we are introducing now this partial coupling cost. So also we are going to try to check per component, which is the coupling cost and this efficiency with the number of resources and the particular execution time per component. And finally, also inside this particular metrics, we define this balancing component. So it's important to highlight that each component has its own scalability curve. So if we are adding more components, as if this setup with the perfect balance is going to be much more difficult. Also, because we have irregular time steps for the different components, for example, IFS is including radiation per some time steps. NIMO is including the ice. The output is done, you know, maybe per one day, these kind of things. And also, maybe you can achieve the perfect balance for one particular setup, but now we include a new component and we have to repeat again all this process. So now I have introduced a little bit the new metrics that we are working or we are going to include in Lucia in collaboration with Fairfax. And I'm going to give you some basic example about in which particular cases these are useful. These two are the typical ones, so it's not going to give more details. So we have simulation just per day, for example. In this case, we can know that the case ACE is faster and the time to solution is better for this particular configuration. But actually with the core hours, we can know that the case B or white in this case is actually more efficient in the computational point of view. And maybe this could be important for the final decision of which setup we are going to choose. So for the next one, and this is more interesting for these couple models. So imagine that we are starting for this particular setup using ECR, and in this case, to simplify only IFS and NeMo. So in this particular case, we can see that actually NeMo is slower. So we want to, in this case, we are going for the time to solution, but it's important to highlight that if we go for the energy to solution, we want to use the same number of processes and try to evaluate different setup. This is possible also with the metric that we are introducing. So in this case, we want to increase this simulation just per day with all the resources that we can. So, well, and here we can see the pattern. No, it's very simple. No, NeMo is slower. So in all cases, we can see that there is the other component which is waiting. So in this case, according to the state of the art, we have to try to balance both components, IFS and NeMo, to the same simulation just per day. And this is the results. And we can see that actually the final couple execution is 20% slower than the simulation just per day of the components. This could be, for example, something related with interpolation time, sometimes, no? But actually it's not the case in this particular example, which is a real example. We can see with the dependencies graph that actually both components are waiting at the same time, even though the simulation just per day for both components is exactly or is pretty similar, actually both of them are waiting. It's not related with interpolation time, no? You can see also this here. So we can see this with the pattern. So in the case of NeMo, NeMo is waiting only for this particular time steps where radiation is done for IFS. Because you can see that NeMo have like a regular time step all the time, but in the case of IFS, per four time steps, there is a higher time step, which is the time which the radiation is done. So at the end, in this particular case, NeMo is waiting some of the cases and IFS is waiting in most of the cases for NeMo. So at the end, both components are waiting. So if we try to do a more evaluation about what is happening with the next one slide, we can use this partial coupling cost that we defined before. So with this partial coupling cost, we can see that actually even though they are waiting pretty similar time and we have the similar simulations per day, the partial coupling cost of IFS is much higher. The reason is very simple. We are using for NeMo these 150 processes, and for IFS to achieve this particular execution time, 500 processes. So at the end, we are wasting a lot of resources for IFS to achieve this particular couple execution. So something that we can do is try to change this. So reduce this coupling cost. We can do, in this case, we are going to increase the speed of NeMo. So in this case, we can see like an imbalance at the beginning example where NeMo is faster, but actually this is the real balance configuration. In this particular case, we can see that the final simulation just per day is the same one than the slower component. With the particular pattern, now we can see that for the regular time steps of IFS and NeMo, they are more or less, we achieve the load balance, and only there is some waiting time in the cases of the radiation execution of IFS. So this also means that it's impossible for some particular configuration achieve a minima waiting time of zero, but we can use this particular metric to achieve this minimum waiting time and try to do this load balance of the models. We were coming from, so a summary from this before the analysis, and then with the technically balanced configuration, we achieve something better, but actually there is an optimal, which is we achieve this 16% of the execution and also improve even the efficiency with the core hours. So intuitive methods can fail to achieve the best solution, but we propose that it's necessary to have a tool, in this case Lucia, or more performance metrics to do this analysis better. So this is the final example to try to provide you more information. So in this case, we have more components. It's not only two. IFS and TM5 are the slowest component, and they have an overhead due to some waiting time. NeMo is almost half of this time waiting, and LPG gas is the fastest component in this case. The last one is TM5. So we are going to do the same study. We go to the partial coupling cost and we see that actually is LPG gas the higher. So in this guide, we go to the pattern again, and we can see that actually there is some way, some kind of initialization, but inside the time step. So this is not the typical initialization and finalization at the beginning of the model. This is inside the first time step of LPGS. So actually, we can see with the pattern that LPGS is introducing a lot of, is a bottleneck for the rest of the model, but only at the beginning of the execution. So next one. At the same time, also, we know that LPGS with this pattern only communicate every 24 hours. So actually, it's a problem at the initialization, but we know that for the rest of the time, the coupling is very negligible in the case of LPGS. So we propose here to reduce the number of cores to the minimum for LPGS because the problem is only the initialization, and try to do the balance for the rest of the components. So now, after this change with LPGS, we go for the partial coupling cost again, and we see that NeMo is the next one to change. In this case, we want to reduce NeMo waiting time. We have here the graph. But the question is how we can know if we have to, for example, give more resources to AFS or TM5, or which is the particular dependency that we have here. We can see this with this dependencies graph. So in this case, we see that it's impossible at the beginning to know this waiting time is coming from one or another component, but with this kind of graph is possible. So in this case, NeMo is waiting for AFS, therefore we have to give more processes to AFS. With this, we will improve the use of the resources. And also, you have taken into account that TM5 is also waiting for AFS. So we can solve this particular problem and speed up IFS is going to improve all the execution. And this is the final result. I have to say that this is a real configuration that we take in our supercomputer, and we try to improve for the user which are using this Earth system model. At the end, we improve a 14%, only try to do this balance with the number of, with the process that we were using, and increase the final simulation just per day, and also reduce the core hours that we were using. So at the end, also something that we have to think is we want to do this manually, or we want to try to take these performance metrics and in some way improve in a more efficient way. So using this particular performance metrics, this is the automatic methodology that we are proposing and we are developing for our experiment. So the idea is minimize the waiting time to the minimum with this coupling cost, this partial coupling cost, and this method is going to iterate until the solution desired by the user is satisfied. So this is for the time to solution, increasing the resources, energy to solution, taking into account efficiency, these kind of things. So we are going to run the experiment, get the metrics, evaluate which is the bottleneck component, which is the fastest component, and improve respect to the previous case, depending on the requirement of the user. Something similar to the last example that I presented. It's also true that we are talking about improve in automatic way the typical example which we are working just right now, CIMIC 6 or the future CIMIC 7 or whatever, in a more static way. No? So we run experiment and we ensure with the method that we are using that we are not wasting resources and we achieve the best simulation just per day. But also this particular metrics is something that you can use for whatever in the way that you think. But the most important is that this coupling cost, we have to ensure that we know all the details needed to do the evaluation of the couple model. So also try to say that, of course, we are also working in dynamic approaches. No, in this case, taskifying MPI calls, something, well, there is more information about this in previous talks, but our idea is try to overlap, for example, computation and communication, try to provide laxity for this communication, and try also to aggregate some load balance libraries to try to do this taskification in a best efficient way, using OMPs, but in this case, something portable, something integrated with OpenMP. This approach actually is going to be tested for IFS, for Deep Sea project, and well, the idea is to prove that this is working and then provide this heterogeneity for Earth system, for couple models. And nothing else, so actually I ran off of the time. So thank you.